Hi everyone, welcome back to the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. And this is actually video number two regarding the new firmware update from the Seestar. And now the reason I'm doing this second video is because I feel like this is a little bit of a Seestar secret. Now the reason why I call it a secret is because I think a lot of people don't know that every time the Seestar app has an update, or the firmware has an update, there's actually a section in the app that will go into detail regarding the update. And at the end of this video, I'll show you how to get to it, but this is how it looks like. It explains further regarding the update. And let's talk a little bit about it. If we look here, the number one item here says it added post-processing feature, which is the deep sky stack, supports free selection of raw images to be stacked to get better images. So this is what it's talking about right here, deep sky stack. And unfortunately, I haven't been able to actually play around with these new features because I've had bad weather here, haven't had clear skies, so I'm kind of bummed out that I haven't been able to try it. But regardless, let's talk about this update. Maybe some of you haven't even been able to get a chance to try it either due to not having clear skies. But those of you that have, feel free to let me know what you've thought about this update. But let's keep talking about this. So the deep sky stack here, it goes into further detail here saying that the purpose of this is to improve the signal to noise ratio of images by stacking for clearer images. So I thought this was pretty cool that they have this update. And the reason why is because most of the time what many of us will do is we'll stack our images in other software, right? So what, once again, this is trying to do, or what Seestar is trying to do here, is have us not leave their app and just stack in their application, which is really nice. However, what everybody's gonna want to know, what everybody's gonna do, is maybe compare, right? Like, I mean, can the Seestar deep sky stack actually live up to other software stacking applications that are out there, right? Who knows? But let's keep in mind that the fact that even the Seestar is coming up with this update is already giving us sort of a little teaser to the future, just because I'm pretty sure whether this feature is good or not at this time, or depending on the quality of this stacking feature, no matter what, I do think it will get better and better. Let's hope that it is good. I wish I could play around with it, but I haven't been able to image, like I've said, due to bad weather. Now let's keep going here. So the number two feature here under what's fresh, it says it's added post-processing feature, video stack, generate clear images of the sun, moon, and planets from the video with one tap. So that's pretty cool. So now we can actually have video stacking besides right here, right? It's image stacking of deep sky, but here it's saying that it's video stacking of the sun, moon, and planets. So this should be really nice too. Perhaps it'll help us be able to pick out more details on the planet, or on, you know, the sun or the moon after stacking. This should be very, very interesting. Once again, will it compare or be just as good as other stacking software out there, or other stacking applications that have been out for a long time that many astrophotographers use? Maybe not, right? But let's not get discouraged about that, because I'm pretty sure, like I said, this is just a glimpse of the Seestar letting us know that things will improve, things should get better. It seems like they always also look for feedback from their customers, you know, from people like us. So yeah, this should be very interesting. I'm excited to use this video stacking feature. Now let's keep going here with number three. Says it added image editing features, brightness, contrast, saturation, sharpen. This is something that I was really excited about. I'm really looking forward to trying this because once again, we don't need to leave the Seestar app to use other apps to enhance, to edit, to post-process your image. So let's see how this works. Once again, I'm curious to see how good this is going to be. As you can see, it's going to have brightness, it's going to have contrast, saturation, sharpen. I'm curious if it's going to have or if it has a noise feature also, or a denoise feature. That would be really nice. So I'm looking forward to using this as well. And if any of you have already tried this, let me know how the quality is and how it's going for you. Now, number four, added image adjustment features on stargazing mode, contrast and saturation. So if we see the difference between these two is that here looks like you can process your image after it's done, right? Once you have your image completed, you can post process. But here you can actually start editing or processing in a way your image in stargazing mode, as in after you've hit the red recording button, you can start to adjust the contrast and the saturation. That seems like it's gonna be pretty cool. I'm also looking forward to trying this. I like how it even has kind of like an undo feature here, the revert button here. So yeah, pretty nice. Let's keep going here with point five. It says they added the album portal on the Seestar page and upgraded the album interaction. So yeah, looks like there's a new little feature here where you can go under a Seestar album and see all your images separated here also by name. So this should be nice too. This should be nice too. I like that. Kind of like a little organizer of images. So or better, it says it's upgraded because they already had that before, right? So it's saying it's an upgraded version of an album. Of the album. Now number six says it added zoom in solar and lunar mode, 1x, 2x, 4x. Let's see also, once again, is this going to perhaps let us have better details of the sun, of the moon, right? Is it gonna look better? Let's see when you play around with it. Let me know if you guys have tried it. Let me know what you guys think. So this should be interesting. Another very cool feature here is if any of us who are doing a scenery mode, it's added an object track. So that's pretty cool to track an object there. And Seestar is saying, give them some feedback, right? Give them feedback on experience, any problems you're experiencing. That's kind of what I like about them is that you know, they want to hear from the customers, right? And they're open to suggestions. I've actually messaged them before. Straight from the app, there's a area where you can report bugs and chat them, so to speak, or really not chat, not a live chat, but send them messages. I have done that and suggested things to them, and let's see if they will put it into practice. But I noticed they're pretty good at getting back with you when you do give them feedback, or if you're having any issues, they're pretty quick at responding. All right, and let's see number eight. I like this one. Supported switching Wi-Fi frequency when connecting to the Seestar for Android devices. Now, I personally do not use the Seestar app on Android. I only use it on my iPad, on my iPad tablet or on my iPhone. However, I think this is pretty cool because it's saying that you can connect to whether you have a 4G, right, or a 5G network. That's pretty cool. And for those of you that do have Android, I would personally suggest to make sure you put your Seestar Wi-Fi on the 5G because I'm assuming that's going to be, better. It's going to be quicker, right? Maybe experience less disconnections from the device and things like that, right? Or from your network. So, and then right here under optimize, to wrap it up, it says optimize the efficiency of image enhancement in stargazing mode, optimize text and user interface. And number three, fix known bugs. Yeah, so that's it, guys. That's what I wanted to show you. And like I promised at the beginning of the video, I want to show you guys how was I able to find this, or how can you find this too in the app. It's very easy, guys. So this is what you're going to want to do. So let me go back here, show you how I got here. Right here, you know, we've got these tabs down here at the bottom, right? Seestar Sky Atlas. Now you go all the way down to this page right here, or this tab. It usually says the word me on there, M-E. And you're going to click on that. You're going to press on that. And it's going to give you this page, okay? Now, when you get to this page, after clicking on that, or after pressing that button right there, you're going to click on the little gear wheel. And then you're going to go to the About feature. Okay, once you hit the About, you'll get this page. And you're going to click on What's Fresh. Once that loads, you're going to see all the other firmware versions that they've ever had and explanations of each one. But of course, we want to see the latest one. So you're going to click on the one at the very top, which is firmware version 1.14. And that's it. That's how you can look into further detail regarding any update that the Seestar firmware has. And that's it, everyone. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you subscribe, and that way you can get notifications as well if you hit the little bell as soon as Astro Room continues posting more videos. Thank you so much, everyone.